One of the biggest challenges for voters on Saturday will be grappling with the ballot paper for the Senate. With 54 parties registered, you'll need both hands to handle it and possibly a magnifying glass. There's been a frenzy of wheeling and dealing for preferences, and it's taken an ugly turn in Queensland. Trevor Borman explains.
They're parties with few followers. Their candidates are largely unknown, but the electoral system gives the so-called micro-parties a crack at a Senate seat with sometimes minuscule votes. Electors on Saturday have a choice of picking a single party above the line in the Senate ballot or preferencing the jumble of parties below the line.
Preferences in Australia have always been a currency to be dealt with, and if these minor parties aren't sincere about their preferences, then that creates problems.
What type of political system do we want in this country?
At the centre of the shambolic wheeling and dealing is the man they call the preference whisperer, self-styled election consultant Glenn Drury. Around the country, Mr Drury has stitched together an alliance of minor parties. He's being paid by the Shooters and Fishers Party and works closely with the Australian Fishing and Lifestyle Party and Family First.
Parties who take opportunistic routes in the end don't last the distance.
Through a series of handshake deals and contracts, these minor parties preference one another over the majors. The alliances mean a few parties look to be contenders for a Senate seat. But cracks are appearing in the alliance. In Queensland, Senate hopeful Patricia Peterson says she was misled. It led to a bitter and highly personal spat. Dr. Peterson took out an AVO against Mr. Drury after he left this voicemail.
I think it's even more disgusting that you would phone a woman, use that sort of language and physically, emotionally threaten her.
Mr. Drury declined repeated requests for an interview and has refused to comment about the dispute with Dr. Peterson. Trevor Borman, ABC News.